Mate, you're a veteran of the Brit Awards.
Oh, I'll take that. A veteran already. That, if I'm a veteran now, what am I in just a couple of years? We'll find out.
I don't know. You take like a, you do like the Masters League Brits.
Great, bring it on.
You take on like Prince and people like that. You've already won like Best Male, Critics' Choice as well. A lot of history with this event, obviously. Any advice for obviously Sam Fender, who's won the Critics' Choice this time round? Fell on Newcastle United fan as well.
Sam is a Newcastle fan, which is brilliant, as are we. Sam is a Critics' Choice winner as well. I'm a big fan of Sam myself. Advice for him, tonight is the night that he can sit back and chill.
Well, he's already won it.
He's got it. So, and I remember, I remember that night. It's like, it's a wonderful thing. It's somehow it's still a sort of nervous occasion because this is a big fancy event and like, I don't know.
Talking to legends like me.
Well, there you go, exactly. And he's probably only done so much of that at this point, so he's still fresh to it. But I think just honestly, enjoy it.
Like, it's kind of like your wedding day, isn't it? That's what people say.
It's a little bit like, I guess. And it's a massive room and it's all a bit of a sort of spectacle, the whole thing. But like, he's every right, obviously, to be here, and it's, you know, it's a huge achievement to get the Critics' Choice, and he's holding a trophy now, you know, and that's...
Got to not lose it.
Don't lose it. You know, don't lose it in the tour bus.
Yeah.
Enjoy the experience, and like, you know, there's a load of mad brilliant music as well, so, and pretty decent drinks.
And the food might be okay as well.
There you go.
Obviously you're releasing new music this Friday, single?
I am. I've got a new single coming this Friday. I've got a wonderful singer called Julia Michaels. I'm a big fan of Julia. We met in the last couple of years. We got together, last year was full of touring for me, but I sort of found a couple of gaps to write, and I'd met Julia and I'm a fan of her music, and I sort of thought, I need to find a window because you know, so that we can get together and write a song. And we've done it. We've managed to do it a couple of times since, but it was the first song we wrote that is the song we're putting out on Friday.
Oh, that's cool. So the immediate spark just became the single. That's amazing stuff. You're going to be playing with Ed Sheeran and The Darkness.
You know what? I've got my eye on this out. I'm very excited to be playing with Ed, but The Darkness are doing the UK shows.
Right. Okay.
I'm gutted. I would love to get up and do. What's a Christmas tune? They've got that amazing Christmas song.
Oh yeah, Don't Let the Bells End. That
amazing.
One.
Amazing.
Yeah.
What a song. which I hope they play in the middle of summer.
Yeah.
So The Darkness are doing the UK shows. I'm doing the European stuff. But Ed is a fantastic person, as we all know. And he, I guess we met. He got on stage with me in 2015, which was madness. But I was.
You need better security.
Tell me about it. No, he nailed it. He got up and did Let It Go with me. And now he's inviting me out around Europe. So I'm excited.
Well, finally for now, you're back. You've got a lot of festivals ahead of you once again. Is there any particular part of cabin you're looking forward to getting back to?
Oh,
because you spend all your time in Potter Cabins as an artist in the festival.
You're absolutely right. Yeah. I don't know. I know. I remember Isle of Wight had that like fancy. They got them like
Winnebago-y sort of thing.
They got the Winnebagos in the tents. I enjoy them. So
awesome stuff. Finally, for now, we've got a big bag of sweets. Do you want a sweet from us? You can have an after-eight mint if you fancy it.
I'm going to be classy.
Yes. Get in there. Lovely old job.
It'll keep me a little bit fresh and sweet in the deal.
Thank you so much.
After-eight, there you go. Cheers, mate.